Number two of my Palladium Books surprise package for Christmas 2017 has come in. I'm really excited. As I said last time, I was going to get a second, and I did right away. If you actually had read the weekly note from Palladium Books publisher and game designer Kevin Simbita this past Friday, he mentioned in depth about the Christmas grab bag program, and he mentioned that someone had already placed a second order, and that it was someone who had just received their package midweek. I'm pretty confident that was me. So that's kind of cool. It's neat to be recognized in that way as someone who is really excited about getting taking advantage of this wonderful opportunity to get a variety of products at a very reasonable price. As I mentioned last time, the Palladium Books surprise gift package costs only $45, and they guarantee at least $90 worth of product. So you get at least 50% off. With my first order, I got $102 worth of product. So occasionally you get a really good deal. I did want to do one brief apology. This goes out to the Palladium Books gang. I was so excited to get the package, and I was so excited to place that second order that I had blinders in many ways on the regarding the types of items I was interested in requesting as part of my wish list. After the fact, I read a little more in detail on the rules of it. And I know I had mentioned you have to order around 10 items, and that's right. I don't know if I mentioned that when I placed my first order, I ordered a couple less than 10, and I did that again this go around. And there is a specific note here that I want to read because I'm going to be ordering a third grab bag gift package for sure. I'll probably wait for another, few weeks until my next paycheck probably. But I definitely want to get another one because I want to actually have a lengthy list with a variety of items that I wasn't thinking about at the time that have kind of come to me as I've looked through the Palladium Books online catalog. Things that I'm like, what, that I thought, why didn't I think of that? That's something I'd be really interested in. And also some kind of knick-knack kind of items and collectibles that might be really neat that I'd be happy to have. So for my third Christmas surprise package that I'm going to be ordering, I'm really going to follow the rules. But I did want to read the little note regarding the rules and the items. It says, each order is handpicked by Kevin Simbita from a wish list you provide. Please list at least 10 to 15 items that you know are in stock. Please do not list books you know are out of print. You will not get them. Note, list 8 or fewer titles and your order may be rejected or you will get items not on your list. I ordered less than 8 with this one. Obviously they didn't reject the order. But we'll see if I get some items that I wasn't particularly angling for. So let's get to it. Let's open my second Palladium Books Christmas surprise package. As I did last time, I actually got out the razor and cut the tape so I can flip it open and we'll see what's in the contents of the box as I do the unboxing. Alrighty. So, as last time, invoice, open house information. As I mentioned last time, I am going. I'm going with my friend Brad. We're going to be there Friday and Saturday. That's late April, and I'm really excited about it. I can't wait. We got our admissions purchased. I reserved the hotel rooms, so we're just waiting to get to April. Here's the 2017 surprise package details. I'm going to add my other one to it right away. And then their checklist. And let's see what I got. Yes. This was number one on my wish list. Rift's Northern Gun 1. This is the industrial hub in the Rift's Earth setting. In the UP, the Upper Peninsula of Michigan. And again, as I told you, I'm planning this Rift's Wausau, where the campaign is based out of a rifted version of my hometown here in Wausau, Wisconsin. Essentially, it's halfway between Chicago and, you know, the far UP cities. And so I think Wausau would be an ideal spot for commerce to be coming through. Also black market stuff, and also Wausau is known for getting its start as an industrial city because of a river that runs through it. So the idea is that Rift's Wausau would have some business dealings with the Northern Gun area. The other thing I really wanted this for is one thing I don't think I've ever put in my Rift's games enough or that I hear about enough is giant robots. Big Robotech fan, I am. I know I've placed Robotech Mecha, ported them from the Robotech RPG into the Rifts setting. But having some Rifts-specific robots, giant robots, is going to be really cool. I've got another fun idea for Rifts Wausau that big giant robots would be an important component of. So I'm flipping through it real quick, and oh my gosh, is there some beautiful art in here. When I quit reading Palladium books, or when I got out of gaming 10 years ago, I'm pretty sure Walton was not doing a lot of art at that time, or he might not even have been a regular artist at that time, because he's a new artist to me, and I see that his work is really well regarded. He's in a lot of Palladium books. Of the last 5+ years. I really dig it. He does pencil work that is really, 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 really interesting and really quite stunning at times. So that'll be pretty. And I guess he also did the cover on this one. Yep, he painted the cover on this one, which I think is a really cool cover. So very cool. Let's see who signed this one. If you recall, with my last package, there was no Kevin signature. I suspected that perhaps he was sick or out of the office on business, and we'll see who we have on this one. Yay! Yep. This is really cool. It's got Kevin signing it, and he also has a little note, armor up, which is really cool. Alex, Wayne, Julius, and the artist, who must have been in the office, Chuck Walton. That's really cool. So this was the number one item on my wish list, and I'm glad I got it. Number two on my wish list was Rift's Black Market Sourcebook. As I just outlined, Wausau being located kind of halfway between Northern Gun area and the Burbs, or the Chicago area in Rift's Earth, Wausau very likely may be a thoroughfare for black market stuff in action. So this, in addition to the Northern Gun book, in addition to the Atlantis book, will be, and basically those are the three main books I really wanted to help me flesh out my ideas and plant seeds for story ideas. So that's really cool. This should be interesting. Based on what I read, there's a lot of good Walton art in this again. What I'm interested in, though, is some of the different crime families, for want of a better term, the different syndicates. I think that'll be really neat. So, very cool. I'm thrilled to have this. And signatures. Another fun note from Kevin. got contraband, and then Alex, Wayne, Julius, and Walton again. So super cool. I'm really happy to have this. Ooh, this was one I that wasn't at the top of my list, but that I was very interested in having after I did some research on it, is the Psyscape World Book 12. There's a whole bunch of different psychic character classes. I'm getting this primarily for myself as a player. I've always found the Burster RCC super cool in the core original Rifts book. This has like an electricity type burster that I want to roll up as a character. I've always liked electricity coming out of your fingers and off your body, those types of superhero characters, and that visual is so neat to me. So the fact that I can essentially do a burster but with electricity is really cool and really attractive to me. But there's a whole bunch of other psychic RCCs throughout this book that I understand. Looks like there's some new beasties, some wonderful art by Ramon Perez, who's now, he did a lot of work for Palladium back in the day. Now he's very busy in the professional comic book field doing art. But his stuff is always so stunning. And also, I've always pronounced it Wayne Broy, another one of my favorite artists from about 10 years ago, 10, 15 years ago. I love his work. This book is hitting all the sweet spots for me art-wise. So, very cool. I'm glad to have this. Very, very pleased to have that. And then, Rifts DBs of North America World Book 30. This was lower on my wish list, but definitely one that I was interested in. I understand this kind of pulls together a lot of the different DBs from many different source books all in one spot. These also can obviously be used for RCCs if the players and the Game Master will allow it, so that they can make some really unique characters for their campaign, or for, really neat characters for their running through a Rifts campaign. So I am really glad to have this. This is a really great collection of books. And like last time, let's do a quick add up. Give me a moment or two to do the arithmetic in my head. 50, 75, and 95. Got over $90 worth of product for only $45. Thank you, Kevin et al. All over there at Palladium Books. This was a treat, and thanks for not penalizing me for not following the rules. I will be doing one more. I will be following the rules, and I think that'll be a real mixed bag of items. I'm really excited to get that out sooner than later. I look forward to seeing other Palladium fans as they open up their, as they do unboxings of their Palladium Books Christmas 2017 gift package /grab bag. Thank you so much for watching, and it's been fun. Thanks.